Dear students, welcome to this video. In this video, we will be discussing about determinant. So let us start with introduction of determinant. What is a determinant? Corresponding to every square matrix, there is associated an expression which is known as a determinant. Let us make it clear with the help of an example. Suppose matrix A is having elements 3, 2, 1, 5. So with respect to this matrix A, we can write an expression like this, 3, 2, 1, 5, which is denoted with this notation. This is known as determinant A with respect to this matrix. The basic difference between matrix and determinant is that matrix is simply an arrangement of numbers. It cannot be evaluated, whereas a determinant is having its value. This can be evaluated. So you see how we can evaluate this determinant A. First of all, in this determinant of order 2, this is a matrix of order 2 by 2. So this determinant A is known as determinant of order 2. So in this case, first multiplying elements along principal diagonal, 3 into 5, 15, minus rest 2 elements, 2 and 1, 2 into 1, that is 2. So finally, the value of this determinant is 30. Now let us see how to evaluate a determinant of order 3. For evaluating a determinant of order 3, suppose we are having determinant A. Determinant A like this, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So before evaluating this determinant, we must know what is minor. With respect to each and every element, we will have a minor that can be obtained by omitting the corresponding row and column. As for example, if you have to evaluate minor of A11, simply we omit this row and this column. The remaining elements are here A22. A23, A32, and A33. So determinant having these elements is known as minor of A11. So this is minor of A11. This is denoted as M11. Similarly, if you have to find out minor of this element, A2, will omit this row and this column, and rest elements are A21, A23, A31 and A33. So here minor of A12, minor of A12, which is M12, this is a determinant having elements A21, A23, A31 and A33. Similarly, minor of Aij element is denoted by Mij. Now, next we must know what is cofactor. In any given matrix, we can have cofactor with respect to each and every element. In the same matrix or determinant which we are considering just now, A, determinant A having elements A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, and A33. Let us try to find out cofactor of this element. The process is same as we evaluated minor. We have to delete this corresponding row and column, and the remaining elements are A22, A23, A32, A33. So cofactor is denoted by C. Cofactor of A11 is denoted by C11. So in this case, we will get A22, A23, A32, and A33. Here, this is important to note that minor and cofactor both are same with respect to this element. But whenever you will evaluate cofactor of this element, this will be minus of minor A12, negative of minor A12. So for that, you just remember this formula that Cij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j and Mij. Since here Ij is 1 and 2, so 1 plus 2 will be 3 here, odd number. So that's why cofactor of this element will be minus of minor of this element. So this is clear that when I plus j is even number, then cofactor and minor both are same. Whereas if I plus j is odd number, cofactor will be negative of minus of corresponding minor. Now it is simple, this is easy to understand how to evaluate a determinant of order 3. Suppose our determinant A is having elements 2, 1, minus 3, 4, 2, minus 1, 5, 3, and 4. And we have to evaluate it. This is important to note that determinant can be evaluated with respect to any row or any column. But generally, we prefer to expand a determinant with respect to first row. So you see how we can evaluate this determinant. So take this first element here, 2, and find cofactor of this element by omitting first row and first column. Remaining elements are here 2, minus 1, 3, 4, plus next term into cofactor of 1. As we have discussed just now, cofactor of 1 will be negative of minus of minor of this 1. So we can put here multiplication with minus 1, and the corresponding minor will be obtained by omitting the elements of first row and second column. Remaining elements are 4, minus 1, 5, and 4. Now let us take third element, plus third element is minus 3. We'll write here cofactor with respect to this number minus 3, which will be obtained by omitting first row and third column, and since here I plus j will be even number, since I is 1 first row and j is 3 third column, so I plus j is 4 even number, so cofactor of this element minus 3 will be as that of minor of this one. So simply deleting, omitting the element of first row and third column, remaining elements will be here 4, 2, 5, 3. And we have already discussed how to evaluate determinant of order 2. You know it very well. So let us evaluate now. This is 2, finally multiply 2 and 4. This is 8, minus of this much, means it becomes plus 3. This plus and minus, minus 4 into 4, 16, minus 5 into minus 1, minus 5, so it becomes plus 5, again this plus into this minus 3, finally we will write minus 3, here 4 threes are 12, minus 5 threes are 10, so this is equal to 11 into 2, 22, minus 23 and minus 3 to the 6. So value of this determinant we are getting is minus 7. So in this way we can evaluate the determinant of order 3 or more than order 3 by multiplying elements of any row, probably particularly first row, we prefer first row, with the corresponding cofactor of these elements, so we will get the answer very easily. So that's all about introduction and evaluating of determinant. So I hope you might have got this determinant chapter useful for you, and I would like to request you to subscribe this channel so that I could give you every update in time. And I would suggest you to share this video with your friends so that they could also get benefit from it. Thank you very much.